Occasionally, NASA makes the news not because they did something super inspirational or fantastic or crazy cool amazing, but because people just don't get it. This is one of those times. Howdy, partners. This is DNews. Thanks for coming by. I'm Trace Dominguez. Mercury is the innermost planet in our solar system. It's both really hot and also pretty cold. It's zipping around the sun every 88 days, but to be honest, we actually didn't know that much about it. So NASA launched MESSENGER in 2004 to explore it. It arrived in 2011, and it's been orbiting ever since. It's learned about volatile compounds on the planet, its magnetic field, that there is ice in their shadowed craters there, and about ancient tectonic and volcanic systems that shaped the planet we see today, among other things. But now, this week, today, MESSENGER crashed into Mercury on purpose. MESSENGER hit the planet going 12 times the speed of sound, with the force of a semi-truck going 300 miles an hour, and it will leave a crater the width of a basketball court. Every month or two, Mercury is hit by a meteor about the same size as MESSENGER, going 10 times as fast, so it's not going to do any real damage. But MESSENGER was out of fuel, and it was literally flying on fumes. Compressed helium, which wasn't designed to alter its course, had been MacGyvered into the task to extend the science just a bit longer. But can you really learn something just by crashing into a thing? Apparently, yes. But in this case, we won't know for a long time until this probe has provided any more insight to what's beneath the surface of that planet. This isn't the first probe crash by any means. Accidents do happen, like in 1966, when humans made their first physical contact with another planet as Russian probe Venera 3 crashed into Venus. It was supposed to land and measure the atmosphere, but it didn't. Mostly, crashes are purposeful, like when NASA purposely crashed Skylab in 1979, or in 2003, when Jupiter's Galileo probe purposely crashed into our largest planet after a 14-year mission. Long before Galileo's crash, it released a smaller probe, which flew into the atmosphere to test it for speed, composition, density, and temperature. But when Galileo hit those clouds, the friction burned her up and the gravity and density crushed her. But they did it on purpose. Galileo had learned that there might be underground saltwater oceans on Europa nearby, and if they simply allowed the spacecraft to orbit Jupiter forever, it could crash into those oceans, contaminating them with Earth bacteria, and that would be horrible. So instead, he intentionally crashed it, and now are designing a potential Europa mission to explore those oceans. In 2005, NASA crashed into Comet Tempel 1 with a washing machine-sized probe named Deep Impact. They hit at 37,000 kilometers per hour, watching from an orbiter nearby to capture the science coming out of the probe. The scientists wanted to get under the skin of the comet and see what they're made of. The impact was, quote, bigger than expected. It was like a mosquito hitting a 747. This whole mission had to be like a string of That's What She Said. Anyway, they spent months analyzing the data from the crash, and they were able to take pictures of the comet as the tiny probe smashed into its surface. Missions like this likely informed the Rosetta Philae comet mission that you may remember from very recently. And most recently, LADEE and Grail's Ebb and Flow have all crashed into the moon. While the crashes themselves don't always teach us much, you can't get data from a dead probe after all. Why do we crash them? We can learn by watching their explosions, by studying the craters that they make, and tracking the results. Physics has rules, and the more controlled variables we have in a crash, the more we can learn. Personally, I also think that there's some kind of theatrical ovation to crashing a probe. Crashing is a way of saying, like, thank you for your knowledge that you've given, now let's blow you up in spectacular fashion. It kind of seems a fitting and final end for any mission. But what do you think? Should we make all of our space probes crash? If you could do anything with these multi-million dollar science projects, what would you do? If you want to know more about expensive science projects, did you know there have been over 90 space telescopes up there? Why so many? Check out this episode of DNews to find out. See, we're only looking at a tiny part of the picture with Webb and Hubble, infrared, ultraviolet, and visible light. We've got way shorter and way longer parts of the electromagnetic spectrum. And while you're at it, subscribe so you get even more videos from us, and thank you very much for watching.